Hey guys, it's Carrie. I'm showing some of my new animals. I have a new turtle, whale shark, and sperm whale. Also some of my more recent animals and all my old favorites. Let me know what your favorite sea animal is. Jellyfish, they subdue prey by using their stingers. Blue-spotted ray, they follow the rising tide onto sandy flats to root for small benthic invertebrates and bony fishes in the sediment. When the tide recedes, the rays separate and withdraw to the shelter of the reef. Megalodon went extinct due to global cooling, shrinking of their habitat, vanishing of their favorite prey, and competition from other predators. Spiny lobster, they can be easily distinguished from true lobsters by their very long, thick spiny antennae and by their complete lack of claws. Leatherback turtle is named from its leather-like covering on its carapace. Octopus, they have a rounded body, bulging eyes, and 8 long arms. Pufferfish are exceedingly hazardous. They carry a toxin called tetrodotoxin, which is deadly to other fish and humans. They have 4 large teeth fused into an upper and lower plate, which are used for crushing the hard shells of crustaceans and mollusks, their natural prey. Clown triggerfish, it erects the first long dorsal spine to impress opponents or to avoid a predator. Catfish, they do not have scales. Their bodies are often naked. In some species, they have mucus-covered skin, which aids in respiration. Salmon, they are anadromous. They hatch in the gravel beds of shallow freshwater streams, migrate to the ocean as adults, and live like sea fish, then return to freshwater to reproduce. Anomalocaris grew up to 1 meter in length. It was the largest hunter of its time. Trilobite, they are extinct marine arthropods. They are one of the earliest known groups of arthropods. Elephant seal, they take their name from the large proboscis of the adult male, reminiscent of an elephant's trunk and considered a secondary sexual characteristic. The bull's proboscis is used in producing extraordinarily loud roaring noises, especially during the mating season. Males display their dominance by showing their noses, making loud vocalizations, and altering their postures. They fight each other by raising themselves and ramming each other with their chests and teeth. Reef squid, they have 2 large complex eyes, 8 short arms near their mouths, and 2 longer tentacles tucked inside, armed with suckers to capture prey. Kemp's Ridley sea turtle is the rarest species of sea turtle and is the world's most endangered species of sea turtle. This one is a hatchling. It has a dorsoventrally depressed body with specially adapted flipper-like front limbs and a beak. They have a triangular-shaped head with a somewhat hooked beak with large crushing surfaces. horseshoe crab. They are marine and brackish water arthropods. They are not true crabs or crustaceans. They are most closely related to arachnids, such as spiders, ticks, and scorpions. Horseshoe crabs live primarily in and around shallow coastal waters on soft sandy or muddy bottoms. Shrimp. They are swimming crustaceans with long, narrow, muscular abdomens and long antennae. Unlike crabs and lobsters, shrimp have well-developed pleopods and slender walking legs. They are more adapted for swimming than walking. Giant squid. They have a mantle, 8 arms, and 2 longer tentacles. The arms and tentacles account for much of the squid's great length, making it much lighter than its chief predator, the sperm whale. The inside surfaces of the arms and tentacles are lined with hundreds of subspherical suction cups. Giant squid and some other large squid species maintain neutral buoyancy in seawater through an ammonium chloride solution which is found throughout their bodies and is lighter than seawater. This differs from the method of flotation used by most fish, which involves a gas-filled swim bladder. The perforation of their teeth and the suction of the cups serve to attach the squid to its prey. It is common to find circular scars from the suckers on or close to the head of sperm whales when they have attacked a giant squid. Killer whale or orca. It is a toothed whale belonging to the oceanic dolphin family, of which it is the largest member. They are found in all of the world's oceans in a variety of marine environments, from Arctic and Antarctic regions to tropical seas. Orcas are apex predators as they have no natural predators. They are highly social. Some populations are composed of very stable matrilineal family groups or pods, which are the most stable of any animal species. Sperm whale. They will dive, and a dive can last more than an hour. They feed on several species, notably the giant squid, but also the colossal squid, octopus, and fish such as demersal rays and sharks. But their diet is mainly medium-sized squid. The sperm whale's respiratory system has adapted to cope with drastic pressure changes when diving. The flexible rib cage allows lung collapse, reducing nitrogen intake, and metabolism can decrease to conserve oxygen. The females and their young live in matriarchal groups called pods, while bulls live apart. Bulls sometimes form loose bachelor groups with other males of similar age and size. As they grow older, they typically live solitary lives, only returning to the pod to socialize or to breed. When sperm whales socialize, they emit complex patterns of clicks called coders. They will spend much of the time rubbing against each other. Their most common natural predator is the killer whale, but pilot whales and false killer whales sometimes harass them as well. The females will protect their calves or an injured adult by encircling them with tails facing out. A tail slap can be a lethal weapon. Octopus. Like other cephalopods, an octopus is bilaterally symmetric with 2 eyes and a beaked mouth at the center point of the 8 limbs. The soft body can radically alter its shape, enabling octopuses to squeeze through small gaps. They trail their eight appendages behind them as they swim. The siphon is used both for respiration and for locomotion by expelling a jet of water. Octopuses have a complex nervous system and excellent sight, and are among the most intelligent and behaviorally diverse of all invertebrates. Gravitoceras, they are an extinct genus of ammonites. They were fast-moving, nectonic carnivores that existed from 84 to 70 million years ago in Japan. And here's another ammonite with its coiled shell. Pleuroceras ammonite. They lived in the seas from at least 400 to 65 million years ago. Their nearest living relatives are the octopus, squid, cuttlefish, and nautilus. Their fossils show a ribbed spiral-formed shell in the end compartment of which lived the tentacled animal. Ammonites swam by jet propulsion, as do most other cephalopods. Humpback whale. Males compete aggressively for access to females in estrus. The breeding season is during winter and breeding takes place in tropical waters. The male follows the female, then they engage in rolling, flipping, and tail fluking. Next, they both dive and then surface vertically with ventral surfaces in very close contact. This is where the male inserts his claspers, which is another word for penis, injecting sperm into the female's cloaca. In sexually mature males, the weight of the testes and the rate of spermatogenesis increase during the breeding season, coinciding with the ovulation of the females. The male's penis length ranges from 1 to 2 meters. Kronosaurus was a marine reptile, a pliosaur. It had an elongated head, a short neck, a stiff body propelled by four flippers and a relatively short tail. Great white shark. This one's by Funko. They have the ability to roll their eyes back when they encounter prey to protect their eyes from sharp claws or barbs. Goblin shark. Their top and bottom teeth are attached to ligaments or bands of skin tissue tucked into its mouth. When prey is just out of reach, the shark extends the elastic tissue out of the mouth to catch prey. Please stay and watch another video with me. I love to read your comments. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video.